recipes, action packs, all the sports. Let's begin with basketball. 28 players, including Captain Aisha Mohammed, have been called up to camp by the Nigerian Basketball Federation ahead of the 2018 FIBA Women's World Cup in Spain. Yes, the World Championship is fast approaching, and so the NBBF, they've called up 28 players, the list which includes 10 players from the triumphant 2017 FIBA Afro Basket team. Don't forget those lovely ladies that went to Mali to win for Nigeria. Is headlined by WNBA stars Evelyn Akato of the Dallas Wings and New York Liberty forward Ife Ibekwe. Invited players expected to report to camp on Wednesday, July the 18th in Atlanta, Georgia. So they're going to be balling right there in Atlanta, get into some good conditioning, play with good facilities so that they can give Nigeria a good representation at the World Cup in Spain. After the first phase of training, the team will return to Nigeria for final camping before traveling to Turkey to play a few warm-up games. The 2018 FIBA Women's World Cup is scheduled for September the 20th till the 30th. So let's wish the Nigerian team, the D-Tigress, all the best. Current African champions, they will be going to that championship to see what they can do right there at the World Championships in Spain. It's going to be very difficult, but I love the steps that the NBBF is taking, getting them ready to go to Atlanta, Georgia, and then they go to Turkey to play some warm-up matches. Yes, just to, you know, get in shape, you know, get more playing time, and of course, blend as a team. I will be rooting for the D-Tigress. They should make us proud in Spain. From basketball, let's go to badminton now. I told you that the Nigerian Badminton Federation, they are doing so much to ensure that the sport is developed. When the new board led by Francis Obi came into office, they promised us that they won't just put badminton in our faces, they will let us talk about it. Over 200 badminton players are from 23 countries expected to participate in the fourth edition of the Lagos International Badminton Classics, which will serve off on Wednesday, July the 18th. Of course, in Lagos, top players from India, Malaysia, and Australia, amongst others, have entered for the competition with $25,000 prize money on offer. $25,000. Yes, that's a lot of money to play for. President of the Federation, of the Badminton Federation of Nigeria, Francis Obi, admits that this year's event will be more competitive than previous editions, but is backing Nigerian players to match up against their foreign counterparts. Yes, because these guys come here and they just get to win everything. So it's good that Francis Obi is saying that Nigerian players can impress. And one way they can impress is by getting more playing time. They need to get playing time, and that's it right there. Let me tell you about the Ghana International Badminton Championships. 10 players are representing Nigeria, 7 men. Francis Obi will tell us why we have just 3 ladies on that team. Anyway, 7 men, 3 women representing Nigeria at the badminton, at the Ghana Badminton International Championships. Good one for these players. It's to get them exposed. They will get ranking points and, of course, do well with their badminton. Anu Oluwakpo Okpeyori, you've seen him here before, is the defending champion of the Lagos, of the national championship, the Lagos edition. Yes, he won that on Clement Krobapo, winner of the championship, the national championship in Katsina, also part of the team. Godwin Olofua. Godwin played the final with Anu in Lagos. It was a beautiful game of badminton, two highly competitive players, but it was Anu that won that one. Godwin, by virtue of all the badminton that he's been playing, went to Ghana today, played the top-ranked player in Africa, and he defeated that player. Isn't that beautiful? That's Godwin Olofua right there. Know your badminton players from Nigeria. Very, very important. Godwin went out there, didn't respect this player from Mauritius, and then went all the way to win. It was an upset. Everyone right there at the Ghana International Championship, they are talking about it. The name Godwin Olofua is big right there. After beating Julian Paul from Mauritius, who is Africa's number one, we keep telling our sports administrators, if you create an enabling environment, the talent is right here. Nigeria is so blessed with sporting talents. Just how to unnest them. It's just how to keep them in shape, do the right things, and they will conquer the world. God will allow for it right there. Ranked number 3 in Nigeria. If the number 3 ranked badminton player can beat the number 1 player in Africa, it tells you the story. It tells you the story. I don't need to talk much more. Daniel Phillips is also part of the male team representing Nigeria. Usman Isiak, Habib Bello, Enojo Abba. Enojo Abba has been the captain of the team for quite some time, comes with a lot of experience, and is part of the team. For the ladies, we have Peace Oji, Dorcas Adesokun. Now, when you talk about Dorcas Adesokun, you talk about badminton, female badminton player with top quality. She is ranked number 1 in Africa. She won the national championship in Katsina, came to Lagos to retain her title with style. Dorcas Adesokun, she's part of the team. I can't wait for her to start playing right there in Ghana so that we can tell her story. Augustina Sunday completes the list of players that will represent Nigeria right there at the Ghana International Badminton Championship. The coaches, Ben Orakpo is the head coach and will be assisted by George Shitta. The Nigeria, the Badminton Federation of Nigeria, they're doing so much. They're training their coaches. They are also saying it's time to take badminton to the schools. Hopefully, we'll get to speak to Francis Obi, who is the president of the Badminton Federation of Nigeria. He says, look, there are a lot of things they want to do with badminton. Now, we like the fact that we're talking about these players. I remember there was a time they went to Indonesia. They've been to some other Asian countries playing badminton. Now, they are in Ghana. When they come back, they will come to play at the Lagos International Classics. Very, very important. Pictures of the national championship in Katsina, where Dorcas Adesokun won. She came back to Lagos to retain her title. Dorcas has been on this show, and for her, she kept on saying she just wants more support for badminton, more following. She was full of praise for the Ogun State Sports Council for the support they've given to her. Not just Dorcas, we need to do the same for Anu, we need to do the same for Clement Kubakpo, we need to do for Godwin Olofua, we need to do for badminton at the grassroots. And that's why it's important that they take badminting back to the schools. Plus, tonight on your award-winning Sports Loving Channels Television, I want you to talk to us. How can we develop badminton in Nigeria? Arguably one of the sports that people use for leisure, but why is he not getting that sort of following? The BFN, they're doing their bit now, getting players exposed, getting them to travel. But I want to read from you. Let's be part of a nation building, particularly if you're a fan of badminton. I know Lagos, they love their badminton. Some parts or some states in the north, they also love their badminton. The southwest also are doing their bit with badminton. I want to read from you guys so that we'll package all of these comments and take it to the BFN that this is what the people are saying. Do this and do that and badminton will be good. The news coming in is also very cheery, and there's hope for badminton. That's Dorcas right there. She is the top-ranked Africa player, and she's a Nigerian, Dorcas Adesokun. We told you that Godwin Olofua today in Ghana at the International Championship defeated Julian Paul from Mauritius. Julian Paul is the number one ranked badminton player in Africa. But when he met a Nigerian today, he learned some lessons. Lessons also for the Badminton Federation of Nigeria. They need to start taking a look. If these players go for more championship, prepare them properly, good welfare packages. Why? How won't we do so well? So we talk about football. That's because everybody's putting attention on football. We used to be so good with volleyball. Let's get back to it. We used to be good with hockey. Let's get back to it. Handball, they're doing their bit. We can't wait for the league to resume again. Our first phase has been done in Abuja. It's coming to Lagos. Let's give him more support so that Nigeria can be a sporting nation once again. That's what we want. So everybody will not just be talking about football. And then when there's a crisis, we'll start wondering, why do we have crisis? Because there's so much attention on it. I love this story coming from badminton. Hopefully, Francis Obi will join us to tell us more. But let's go on this break. When we come back, we'll talk about football, particularly Infantino saying, Amaju Pinnick is still our president. Don't go anywhere. Stay.